Let's discuss the back exercise questions of chapter 5. First question. Describe the climate of Democratic Republic of Congo. Democratic Republic of Congo has a hot and wet climate as this country lies in the equatorial region. The sun shines brightly in the daytime and the temperature remains high throughout the year. By around 3 p.m., the sky is covered with the dark clouds as the water in the lakes and rivers get evaporated, which causes formation of clouds. Every afternoon, there is heavy rainfall by 4 o'clock, due to which nights get cool again and are quite comfortable. Second question. Why does Democratic Republic of Congo have a hot and wet climate? Democratic Republic of Congo have a hot and wet climate because this country lies near the equator, or you can say this country lies in the equatorial region. This area receives direct rays of the sun, which makes the climate hot throughout the year. Due to extremely high humidity, there is heavy rainfall every afternoon, which makes the climate wet. Question number 3. What do you know about the natural vegetation of Democratic Republic of Congo? Due to hot and wet climate, as we know, this country lies in the equatorial region, so there is hot and wet climate over there. There is thick growth of trees, plants and creepers. These forests have tall trees which form a sort of canopy of leaves at the top. Canopy is a shed that is made by the leaves over at the top. The forest is so dense that it doesn't allow sunlight to enter the forest, due to which the forest remains dark and dim even during the day, and it is difficult for the people who are living there to cross the forest even during the daytime. These forests are also called evergreen forests as they do not shed their leaves in one season of the year. They shed their leaves in different seasons of the year, due to which the forest remains green, and that is why these forests are also called evergreen forests. Question number 4. Name 4 animals and birds found in the forest of Democratic Republic of Congo. The animals found here are monkeys, gorillas, African elephant, rhino, chimpanzees, okapi, etc. Okapi is the national animal of Democratic Republic of Congo. Some birds which are found here are hornbill, gold coast, flying squirrel and screeching parrots. Question number 5. Write 5 lines on the life of pygmies. Pygmies are the original inhabitants of Democratic Republic of Congo. Original inhabitants means permanent residents. They are short in height. Their average height is only 1.5 meter. They live in dense forest and lead a nomadic life. Now, what type of life is nomadic life? People who don't have permanent houses, and they used to wander from one place to another in search of food, are called nomads. They rarely cook food. They used to eat raw food. They are excellent hunters. They used to hunt the animals and gather their food like this only. They use sign language, music, drum music and dance are their favorite entertainment? Question number 6. Name some important crops grown in Democratic Republic of Congo. Farming and mining are the main occupations of the people in Democratic Republic of Congo. Now, what are the main crops grown here? People grow maize, banana, vegetables, groundnuts, and cassava. Cassava is a root crop like potato. It just looks like a potato. It is dried and powdered to make bread. Tapioca that we get from cassava plant is used to make bread. Some cash crops like rubber, coffee, rice, and cotton are also grown here. Question number 7. Name the main industries of Democratic Republic of Congo. The main industries of Democratic Republic of Congo are textiles, paper, soap, cement, and cigarettes. These are the main industries of Democratic Republic of Congo. Question number 8. How is the life of the people of Democratic Republic of Congo changing in the modern times? As we know, Kinshasa is the largest city and it is also a modern city with all the facilities. It is a city which is the capital city of Democratic Republic of Congo. It is the largest city with all the modern facilities in that. The country is becoming more and more industrialized and the life of the people is also changing. More and more industries are being set up in the modern city Kinshasa, which is the capital of Democratic Republic of Congo. And the life of the people is also changing due to this reason. It has a good network of roads and railways. Cities are well connected here and this country has a well-developed air transport system also.